So basically, we're living in the future. We've got computers in our pockets, we can FaceTime with people across the world, and a Hyperloop train is on the way. But I want to know, where the hell is my jetpack? Hey guys, Julie here for DNews. Soon! It's coming soon! By the middle or end of next year. But the company is based in New Zealand, so looks like I'll start looking at plane tickets. The Martin Jetpack is the brainchild of Glenn Martin, which he first started imagining way back in the early 80s. Since then, it's been through a few iterations, but this latest version runs on good old-fashioned gasoline. The gasoline powers twin ducted fans that provide the downward thrust necessary to lift a person. The frame is made of lightweight carbon fiber and aluminum. The company's website claims it can reach heights of over 3,000 feet and soar around for about half an hour, and it's only for the low, low, low price of $200,000. But who would want that? Okay, you. You probably would, though the price might make it out of reach for the average Joe to play around with. But it's not just fun and games. These were also designed with emergency responders in mind. Mike Reed, director of flight operations at Martin Aircraft Company, said with its small dimensions, it can operate in confined spaces, close to and between buildings, near trees, or in other areas that larger, very tall aircraft such as helicopters can't access. So that would be pretty cool, if not slightly expensive. So why exactly aren't we all just zooming around in jetpacks yet? Well, when you think of a jetpack, I bet you think of a rocket pack, the harness that straps on your back with two tanks that shoot massive amounts of fire out the bottom, right? These kind of jetpacks could work by combining fuel and an oxidizing agent. When the fuel and oxidizing agent, maybe hydrogen, maybe liquid oxygen, mix, it creates a lot of heat and whoosh, you'd get the hot flame shooting out the bottom to lift a person into the air. Okay, but let's get real. That's not the greatest idea. Like, who wants rocket fuel burning by their nether regions? No one. That's who. So it's not surprising that the Martin jetpack uses ducted fans rather than fire to lift the rider off the ground. Another problem? The noise. The roar of the engine simply makes it too uncomfortable to use. Plus, you can't exactly sneak up on your enemy if they can hear you from miles away. And also, physics. Lift force must exceed weight force, and really the whole reason we haven't had jetpacks yet is humans just aren't made for flying. We're awkward creatures and not very aerodynamic. To get us to fly, the pack would have to do all the work, which means a lot of fuel, which means the pack is just too heavy. So you need a lot of fuel to lift a person. Like, the Army tested a jetpack in the 50s that was only airborne for about 13 seconds, which burned up 25 pounds of rocket fuel. To make a flight last long enough to be enjoyable, you'd need more like 890 pounds of fuel. That doesn't even factor in that the engine would have to be more powerful to carry all that fuel, adding more weight to the whole thing, and it just gets real problematic real fast. One of the possible versions of a jetpack is the Bell Rocket Belt, which uses hydrogen peroxide as the fuel, but there's another big problem with it. Hydrogen peroxide burns fast and hot, but because it burns so fast, the flight time is only about 30 seconds, and that comes with a hefty price tag. It can cost as much as $240 a gallon, and since the flight time is so short, you really can't get high enough to the point where a parachute can catch your fall, so use at your own risk, really. And yes, jetpacks are kind of here. They're nowhere near perfect, and with a little more innovating, maybe they'll get there someday. Speaking of innovation, Intel creates the breakthrough technologies that make amazing experiences possible. Having Intel inside makes for better experiences outside. Intel drives innovation with products like processors, wearables, and IoT devices, and within data centers, in the PC, and beyond. Got any clever ideas for an awesome jetpack? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.